Yeah, baby. Huh?
Thank you all for coming in. We'll give it a little bit more time. Wait for family and friends to come in. Like, share, tag. Like, share, tag.
Come on, move. Yeah, y'all come on in. I know we live. We did live. That's it. Come on in, come on in, come on in. Come on in.
We're excited and we appreciate all of you all that are coming in. Tanisha, Karen, Kelly, we'll see y'all. How you doing, Brad?
Yeah.
Shaquilla, hey, how you doing?
Yeah, text a friend, man. We're excited. We're excited what God is doing.
Hey, Tamika Davis.
Yeah, Rika.
Y'all like, share, tag. This is a virtual book launch, but there is a word. There is an encouraging word. Yes, I'll give it a few more minutes.
I'm holding myself in this. Oh. I'm holding.
Hey, Andrea.
Felicia and Teresa.
Hey, Rochelle. Hey, Felicia. Come on in. Like, share, tag.
Come on in to my room.
He gonna show out, y'all.
Oh, my room. Let me
stop.
Valadero Reddick said he couldn't wait for me to praise dance on the live.
Yes, sir.
Just a few more minutes. As we wait till our start time, we're launching this right here. The Power of Perseverance.
The power of it.
Before we start, I definitely like to give a shout out to those 8 beautiful authors. The sisters of Zeta Alpha Psi, Sharika Reddick, founder, Michelle West, Shalonda Smith, regional, Sharon Blunt, Dean Avente, Sheila Slaughter, Pastor Slaughter, Kimberly Lucas, VP, Carol Evans, VP, ATL.
And yourself?
And myself.
That's right.
I'm a sister's keeper. I overlook myself, friend.
Crystal Smith.
Thank you, baby.
That's right.
Like to give a shout out to Founder Reddick, Deacon Reddick, our co-founders.
Yeah.
October will be 10 years. Thank you for standing in the gap.
10 years.
Hey, Angie Smith. How you doing, sister?
10 years. goodness.
All right, y'all. Let's get it in. I'm ready. Welcome to our live launch.
Welcome.
The Power of Perseverance, a sisterhood experience. All right? You want to start off with Rev here?
Already?
Yes, already.
Already. I thought you were going to do some talking. Get rid of my nervousness.
Oh, Rev, you know you're not nervous. Come on here now.
All right.
Don't even be acting shy.
Okay. Whatever you want to do. You want to greet the people, you want to thank them and everything, you know, welcome them. This is what the book is about and all this good stuff.
I will, friend.
She's nervous.
I am nervous. The book is about the power of perseverance. 8 beautiful authors, 4 different states, and we've taken a 3-day span to share our experiences with you, just a little bit, because we want you to purchase this book. Moreover, support us, really, so that we can get the word of God out of there, okay? Out there to you, all right? Rev Smith, you want me to call you today, Bay?
Call you
Bay, Rev.
I what answer you to you when it come out your mouth.
Hey, Bay.
No, no, I answer to you, no matter how you call me.
Okay, guys. All right. We're getting ready to get started. Like, share, tag. Okay. I know you might say, you know, she wrote the book. They're doing it. Yes, we're doing it together. You know why? Because we're a team, baby. We're a team. We are one, baby. Where I go, he go. Hey, my people is his people. We're a team, baby, and we're not gonna do anything apart. That's right, baby?
That's right.
So my baby is about to give y'all a word of perseverance.
Hey, amen. God bless you, baby. God bless you. Wonderful wife.
Come on here now.
I thank God for you and Pastor, I see Pastor Reddy.
Yeah.
Go ahead and call it.
Pastor
Reddy in the house. To her and her lovely husband down. To you ladies, man, I take my hat off, you know, to all the authors and to all those who, you know, have the same heart like y'all have. That's a part of sisterhood. My wife asked me to just speak on something dealing with the power of perseverance, which is the title of the book of the authors. And I want to read this scripture, and I just want to encourage all the authors. I would encourage all women, and actually men too.
Yes.
You know, about the power of perseverance. You know, there's a power in that, because we can lose that, you know, in our walk for Christ. But there's a power that's given to us through perseverance. I'm gonna read the book of Ephesians, chapter 1. 18 through 22, and you can go back and read it and study it for yourself. And the word of God reads, I pray that the eyes of your understanding may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope of which he has called you. Talking about y'all, we're talking about y'all authors here. The richness of his glorious inheritance in his holy people. Don't you know you have a rich inheritance? And y'all are demonstrating it through this book. Amen. Y'all have a glorious inheritance in his holy people. And is incomparable great power to us who believe. That power is the same as the mighty strength he exerted when he raised Christ from the dead and seated him at his right hand in heavenly realms, far above all rule and authority, power and dominion, in every name that is invoked, not only in the present age, but also in the one to come, and appointed him head over everything in the church.
Everything.
So what I want to encourage everyone that's listening to the the authors of this book, is that you are a person of power and authority. Okay? Because you belong to Jesus. Yeah, we all belong to Jesus, but he has given each and every one a power and authority. Look at this book. I see pictures of which you ladies are so beautiful. And beneath your pictures in the book, there are words explaining you. You belong to Jesus. If it wasn't for Jesus, what would the words say up under your picture? If you didn't belong to Jesus. The power to perseverance. And the author, you know, in Ephesians is Paul, and I was trying to picture his frustration Paul must have as the Holy Spirit was guiding him and using him to write these words to the church. I almost picture him saying, and he's saying this to us today, don't you get it? You are not a destitute people. You are a great people of power and authority. I want God to open your spiritual eyes and your spiritual understanding so that you can truly see and understand, you know what I'm saying, the power of God that works on your behalf as God's children. God is working for me. Y'all say God is working for me. Come on, everybody in this room say God is working for me.
Come on, ladies. We got to prove that behind the camera, y'all. Come on, ladies.
I ain't hear y'all saying that.
A beautiful two daughters.
There you go.
Kiara and Lily.
Oh, say, y'all,
say it again, ladies.
Y'all say God is working for me.
Y'all
He's
hear
working
him?
For me. Yeah. God is working. He's working. And you look, and if you get this book and you read these women's stories and testimony, you can see that God is working for them. The same power that raised Jesus from the dead and the same power that is at work in your life as a child of God. There is no name. No authority higher than Jesus. Somebody ought to shout Jesus. I ain't going to preach. I wasn't going to preach.
Jesus.
I'm just going to talk. Everything has been placed under the feet of Jesus for your benefit. Mm-hmm. Aren't y'all glad that Jesus came? So everything that's done is done for your benefit. That's why you have power of perseverance. Yeah, that's why this book shows me that everyone that read it, that you are a child of God, that you are not destitute. You're not alone. You're not small. You are valuable. You're worth something. This is not the end of your story.
Right.
It's not the end of your story. Right. That's why you as a person of power and authority, because you belong to Jesus who has all power and authority. Yeah. Just throw your hands in the wind and tell Jesus, keep working. Say, Jesus, keep working on me. Two more verses and I'm going to come to a close, okay? I knew that would be Two more scriptures I think is very important for us to understand the power of perseverance as people of God.
Power.
Jesus gives us the assurance that he has given us power to overcome all the power of the enemy and nothing shall harm us. We got all power, not a little power, not somebody speaking over power. I'm talking about Jesus has given us all power over the enemy. That's Luke 10:19. Matthew 18 says, Jesus says, whatever we bind on earth will be bound in heaven. And whatever we loose on earth will be loose in heaven. And if two of us agree on anything that we ask of him on this earth, it will be done for us in heaven. For where two or three are gathered together in his name, there he is.
There it is.
So we got what? How many people on this book? We got 8 people. They came together. It was on one accord and they asked Jesus, and look what happened. Their perseverance developed a book to help women, men, whoever read this. I'm pretty sure you're going to get something out of this. Because because they're talking about what God has done for them. Man, y'all better go get this book. So the question is, do we have that much power as children of God? Somebody say, yes, we do.
Yes, we do.
The book shows us that you are royal sisters. Mm-hmm. You guys possess the power of perseverance. Yeah. Just repeat it to yourself. I got that power.
Yes.
See, Satan don't want you to speak those things and believe it and make it a reality in your life. This book. You know, there are a lot of books out there, but I'm promoting my wife and I'm promoting these other ladies to go purchase this book and come and let us do like Jesus did with the power that God gave me, rise up. Come on, let's get awake and rise up and be perseverances. That's a good word.
People who persevere, all right.
People who have the power of perseverance.
Oh, yes.
You got the power. And that's me. Don't give up, I can tell you.
Don't give up.
Keep the faith. Mm-hmm. Keep walking, keep your head up. You have that power and authority in Jesus Christ. And that's all I have. They told me not to, you know, but well, that's all I have to say. Baby, to encourage the women.
Thank you so much.
Of Zeta, Alpha, Phi, Sisterhood.
He always plays.
But man, congratulations. I would just like to say, baby, for you, congratulations to all the ladies. And even to the ones, you know, that had a desire to write but just didn't see it. But I know now that God has given you that power and understanding that you can persevere and you can tell your story.
Yes.
It don't have to be in this book, but anybody you come across, you might have a story to tell someone that might help somebody on their way. No matter where you're at, Walmart, we all in Walmart.
Yes.
Grocery stores, you know, wherever you may be, restaurants. Use your power, perseverance, to speak life into somebody for what God has done for you. I'm done.
Let him use you.
That's
your word. Say that. All right, y'all. I wanted to read a scripture that came across to me when I was thinking about what will I share with, you know, the people, God's people. So I came across a Galatians 6:9. Let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not. Mm. If we faint not. Mm. Let me flip that a little bit. Let us not be tired doing good things, for soon we shall be blessed.
We shall be blessed.
If we don't give up.
We don't give up.
There it is. My daughter gonna get me. I'm messing with her her setup. She giving me that face. Thank you. The power. That word keeps ringing. You know, as Bay, you know, I want to try to keep spirit, but I call him Bay. All right. He kept hitting that word power. And so I said that I would share a little bit, because I don't want to read the whole book to you. My story was about dealing with my fear. Now, I know that may come as a surprise to some of y'all, because you see me so passionate, and some of you may have mistaken my passion for aggression. But it's passion, y'all. Mm. Now, what I dealt with was fear. And my scripture was 2 Timothy 1:7. For God hath not given us a spirit of fear, but of
power.
There it is again.
And of love.
And of
sound.
There it is. I'm going to read a little bit. And then I'm going to get into it just a little bit.
Oh, for the angle by the book, you read the
whole thing. No, I'm not going to read.
No, go ahead.
For as long as I could remember, when I was a small child,
that had always been a fear factor. I had always been afraid of the dark. I was afraid to speak in my classrooms when my teachers called upon me. I was afraid of what people thought of me. I was afraid for no reason. I was afraid of things I had no reason to be afraid of. The most puzzling thing was at times when maybe I should have been afraid, I wasn't. I was ratchet. That factor never dawned on me until I began to share this journey. I had heard it said so many times before that fear is really an acronym for false evidence appearing real. Fear presents fake news, and our imagination, oh, it advertises it and publicizes it to be a greater threat than it really is. I don't want to go any further because I want you to get that book. And if you're dealing with fear, and if God has given you a word to give to the people, but the enemy tries to keep your mouth closed through the spirit of fear, I need you to get this book. Because I really did deal with the spirit of fear. Now today we came in our camo. We came in our camo today. Hey, baby, cause we warriors.
That what it is?
Yes sir.
We warriors. Watch
out. You don't just get to be a warrior. You have to go through training. When I was dealing with that spirit of fear, that was my kindergarten class. Make mistakes. Seemed like I was in kindergarten for what, 38 years, 40 years?
You will tell everybody. Well, you done said it now.
yep. I'm still not telling them what's in the book, dealt with fear. And Lily can testify this, tell you this so that my testimony can help somebody else. So that you can see where he brought me from to where I am now. I dealt with being afraid of the dark. So afraid that I wet the bed up until middle school. Now you can't hold that against me because I'm over 50 now. But I dealt with the spirit of fear. Just that bad. I dealt with the spirit of fear so bad that I would beg my children. When my husband went on the road, truck driving, overnight, I begged my children to sleep in the bed with me. That's how bad I dealt with the fear. And Lily can tell you, right, Lily? In what grade, if you say, Lily say, Mom is kind of weird. And I was so afraid, but I was a grown woman, but I dealt with the spirit of fear. I didn't sleep with my arm over the side of the bed. And my babies, they might have been a little spoiled because I was dealing with the spirit of fear, and I didn't tell them, but I had them sleep with me. Until I began with this women's ministry, TPS, Michelle and Jessica, and I began to study warfare. My God. But I don't want to tell it all. I want you to read this book. Dealing with the spirit of fear, I decided to study God's word. I wasn't able to overcome the spirit of fear without God's word, without the faith to know that God would cover me at night when my hubby was on the road. Don't let something creak at the fireplace. Boy, I'm in the bed all to the morning night. But to God be all the glory. I persevered to study his word. God kept putting things in my way. He kept putting things in my way where I had no choice but to stand up and look fear in the face and declare God's word to fear. God has not given me the spirit of fear. No, baby. I ain't tell the whole book, baby. None of that is in the book. That's from the heart. All right? You got some input, baby.
Yeah, I just want to say this one thing. This one thing that I had came to my thought last night when I was studying about the power of perseverance. And I thought about how the power that God used to raise Jesus mm-hmm. is the same power that can rose you up mm-hmm. out of the spirit of fear. Mm-hmm. And you took control over that spirit. So I just say to everybody, rise up like Jesus, and shake the dust off your feet. Wake up and rise up, people of God. God has given you Jesus and power and authority over your enemy. Yes. Get up.
Get up.
Get up. Nobody battle is the same, but you still got the same Jesus, you got the same power, and yes. you got the same authority. And nothing can harm you. That's what Jesus said. Jesus said nothing will harm you. Yes. We gotta learn to lean and trust that word and believe that it is true. Cause trust me, everything Jesus said, he meant it. Everything God said, he meant that thing. That's right. So that's all I have to say. God bless y'all. God bless these women. God bless this book. May it prosper and add to your life.
I want to give Amen. A couple of thanks.
Go ahead. Give them
thanks. First, I want to thank, give an honor to God who is ahead of my life. No, I'm just, God, yeah, he is. Without God, this would not be possible. Mm-hmm. God whispered, the Holy Spirit whispered, and I was obedient, and I presented to the ladies, and they took it, and they ran with it. So I like to bless God, because he is number one. Secondly, I like to thank my husband. You always be there for me, to support me. Mm-hmm. And I appreciate you.
No problem, girl. I got you.
I'd like to thank my children, Kiara, Lily, Alicia, and Vincent. Sweet Mal, sometimes. Mila. And Mila. Yes, sir. Yes.
She's sweet to me.
And Lily, she always... She pushes me to persevere, to be real. Ma, don't do that. Ma, why are you doing that?
Me, she pull you back.
Yeah, she... And then when I be real, she want... Once I be real, I sure... Then she want me to chill. But thank my daughter. She perseveres to keep me alive all the time. Okay? Yes, sir. Okay. I'd like to thank my mother.
Okay, I'm sorry.
I think my
podcast in a minute.
You're stupid.
A book release. Podcast in a minute. Go ahead, baby.
You know what? I think my mother, Margaret Ann Crosby.
Yeah.
Raised 5 children on just a regular income. And all 5 children went to college. My God. With an iron hand, but she did it.
I'm just joking.
I'd like to thank that Happy Town crew. Y'all welcome me from Delaware. A little rough around the edges, but y'all welcome me. Happy Town. Swanson, South Carolina.
HT, baby. We live and well.
The Smith family. So blessed to be a part of that family. Mm-hmm. So blessed. All right. I want to my brother and sister LaDawn and Andre in Durham, North Carolina, who've been entrepreneurs for over 20 years and showed me the ropes about doing business. That tidbit, because when I was in the streets, when I was in the world, yes sir, just a little bit, I had an opportunity to get some very expensive things for free to start my business. And I always remember, my brother said, Crystal, if you're gonna start your business, start it on the up and up, or else you'll lose everything. And I remember that word to this day. Andre and LaDawn, love y'all. And also my sister Lisa, my oldest sister, who has the power to persevere over 30 years mm-hmm. in the medical field, working from Delaware, Pennsylvania, South Carolina, over 30 years. I love her. She's always been solid. And my sister-in-law, Angie,
the perseverance to raise her daughter after her husband passed and trained her so that she got over 10 college offers.
Lord Jesus.
That's the power of the perseverance.
Oh, grace.
Angie Smith.
Yeah, she did that now.
And last but not least on this one, Pastor Jerome and First Lady Nadine Boyd.
Whoop, whoop.
I thank y'all. Yeah. I thank you for seeing me, giving me a chance and opportunity to work in my gifts. I love you and I thank you for the perseverance and the power that the Lord gave you. But last but not least, I did say that, but myself, the power to persevere, learning how to walk all over again after I fractured my pelvic in 3 places.
Mm, that's right. The power to persevere.
That's right. Amen.
There are so many stories. No, you're not excused yet, friend. Don't show out now. We've been doing good now.
Excuse me. I'm about to get up. Okay, go ahead. You got 2 more minutes.
Say the Appleside Sisterhood. All y'all, love y'all to pieces.
Yeah.
Definitely. And my family and friends. St. Luke, Mount Pleasant. Love y'all to pieces. And also Victory Christian Fellowship in Newcastle, Delaware.
Hey, thank all the men that support their wives.
Oh, definitely.
Yeah, yeah.
They have a side sisterhood. They have husbands that really stand behind their wives. Mm-hmm. And we are so appreciative of you husbands. Yeah. And even male friends. Men of God. Men after God's own heart. That's a little plug. Yes, you'll catch it later. All right, there are more stories in here. These stories will break out of bondage if you allow it.
Mm-hmm.
The book is in the link. Y'all go ahead and if we don't have any questions, nobody gonna put any questions in here. What we're gonna do is I'm gonna ask Mister. I'm gonna ask my sister-in-law.
There you go.
Roshonda, to come pray us out. And pray over your dreams and your desires. Baby, go get that black over there, please. Please, go ahead and handle her over there, because she's about to come. I'm like, Willie D now. Grab the black jacket, please.
Black jacket?
Yes, yes. She old school, y'all.
Oh.
My sister-in-law don't like them arms out. The mother of the church might get her.
You stupid.
Baby, y'all, you got my dress.
Come on. You all right.
I'm
we're going to ask her to pray over your dreams and your desires,
fears,
mm-hmm. your struggles,
mm-hmm.
relationships that you need to get out of, forgiveness
mindset.
That you need.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, yes. I want you. I want you here, sis. Sis, I want you here. Come on, sis.
I need to move.
No, you do not. I'm coming back behind sis.
That's my beautiful sister. She's single. Come on, Shanta. Shanta la caca.
Lord have mercy. Greetings, everyone. God bless you all. Thank you all for tuning in this afternoon for the live book release. And as we go before the Lord in prayer, I'm going to encourage you to tune your hearts and your mind in and put your mind on those things that you desire from God. And take your mind off of the things that are distracting you from going forth with what God has assigned you to do and those things that you desire to do that are in the will of the Lord. So let's go forth in prayer. God, we thank you right now for this opportunity, Lord God, to come before you in prayer, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for your grace and for your mercy, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for Jesus Christ, who you sent to die on the cross for our sins, and he rose on the third day with all power in his hands.
Yes.
He got up, Lord God, and because he got up, we can get up, Lord God.
Yes.
And so, God, we thank you for that. We thank you for the blood of Jesus that covers us and keeps us and heals us, Lord God.
We ask you right now, Lord God, to forgive us for everything that we've said and done, God, that was contrary to your word, Lord God. Those thoughts that we pondered on and dwelled on, Lord God, that were ungodly, Lord God. Those things that we allowed ourselves to be distracted by, Lord God. We ask you, God, to forgive us, God. For when you gave us an assignment, Lord God, or a task to do, Lord God, and we deliberately ignored it, Lord God. We deliberately disobeyed you, God. Father, we ask you to forgive us, God, in Jesus' name. Jesus. And God, we come to you right now, Lord God, interceding for all, Lord God, in Jesus' name, who have a dream and a desire, Lord God, to go forth, Lord God, with a book, Lord God, with a business, with a ministry, Lord God. We present them to you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God. And God, we ask you to give them wisdom, knowledge, and understanding, Lord God. Because your word says, Lord God, it all comes from you, Lord God. Your word says, ask and it shall be given. Seek and we shall find. Knock and the door shall be open, Lord God. And so, God, I come to you right now, Lord God, interceding for them, Lord God, asking you to endow wisdom and knowledge and understanding, Lord God. Because, God, in order for us to go forth in those, with those dreams and those ministries, Lord God, we have got to have godly wisdom. We've got to have understanding, God, because your word says, all thy getting, get understanding. So, God, we ask you to lead and guide us, Lord God. Order our steps. Your word says the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. And, God, we ask you to order our steps as we go forth, Lord God, seeking your face, seeking your guidance, Lord God, seeking your word, God. As the woman of God has already said, Lord God, if it had not been for your word, Lord God, we need your word that is the lamp to our feet and the light to our path, Lord God. And so, God, we thank you for your word, Lord God. And even those of us, Lord God, who don't read your word all the time, who don't study your word all the time, Lord God, who may not even understand, Lord God, we ask you, Lord God, to give understanding. Give us that hunger and thirst for righteousness, Lord God. Give us that hunger and thirst, Lord God, to read your word, to know your word, to want to know you more and more, God. Because, God, you are immeasurable, God. You are unlimited, Lord God. We will never know all that we need to know about you, Lord God. Only that which you allow us to know, God. But we, even that, Lord God, we want to know. We want you, God. We want you to get the glory out of our lives, Lord God. We understand, Lord God, that when we say, Lord, have your way in our life, that includes, Lord God, trials and tribulations, Lord God. But even in that, Lord God, you are teaching us, you are pruning us, you are purging us, God. You are disciplining us, Lord God. And so we thank you for that, God. But your word said you will never leave us, and you sure enough won't forsake us, God. And so, God, we thank you for that, Lord God. And, God, we thank you for birthing out all dreams, all ministries, all those gifts that's been lying dormant, Lord God. All those gifts and dreams, Lord God, those assignments, God, that you've given, Lord God, that's been lying dormant, God, because of fear, because of doubt, Lord God, because of anxiety, Lord God, because of low self-esteem, Lord God. We come against all of that in Jesus' name, Lord God, and we cast it down to the pits of hell, Lord God, and we speak life to those dreams. Hallelujah. We speak life, Lord God, to those ministries, Lord God, those businesses, Lord God, that you have instructed them to do, Lord God. We speak life, God, and they will give birth. We're going to speak out that they will give birth, Lord God, in this season, Lord God, and you will get the glory. We get joy, and you get glory, Lord God. And so, God, we thank you right now, guys. We leave from this life, Lord God, in Jesus' name, that you are pleased, God, with everything that's been said and done, Lord God. And every ear they hear, every eye that sees, God, is blessed, Lord God, in Jesus' name. And you get the glory, Lord God, because all glory belongs to you and you only, Lord God. We dare not take the glory, Lord God, that belongs to you. We dare not take the praise, God, that belongs to you, because all of it belongs to you, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, God, we thank you, Lord God, for the success and the prosperity of every gift, every book that's been written, Lord God, in this season, God. And many have been written, Lord God. And God, we thank you for every author, because, God, we know that the book idea came from you and you only, Lord God. And so we thank you and we give you glory, Lord God, as we dismiss and leave from this life, Lord God. But we know that your presence will forever dwell in us, Lord God, and those that are watching, God, your presence is everlasting and ever dwelling, God. So we thank you right now, God, for it being done. And all these things we count it done in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And give God the glory.
Amen. Amen. Just close us out all the way out. A little song. Just a little verse of it. I love to. Yes. All the glory.
All the glory belongs to you. All the glory belongs to you, oh God. Yes. All the glory belongs to you. All the glory belongs to you, oh God. Yes. All the glory belongs to you. Belongs to you, oh God. Oh, all the glory belongs.